Horses become more than the thousands micrograms per cubic meter. The level of air pollution has increased from sixth of the limit in 2007 to more than 60 times in early 2015. The peaceful protesters were stopped violently by the Iranian authority, and a number of them were arrested. River diversion and draining of the marshes are turning once fertile land into desert, while industrial pollution has made our city the most polluted place on the earth consecutive years since 2011. According to the World Health Organization, the Ahwa has become the most polluted city in the world, as well as destroying the unique ecology of the region. The effects have been devastating from the indigenous Ahwazi Arabs population. Over centuries, the climate and environment of Ahwaz have depended on the rivers flowing through the region. The Karun, Karkhe, Dez, and Jarahi rivers play an important role in the conservation of the marshlands of Falahiyya and Hawr al-Azim. The life of the Arab farmers depends on the river's water. Moreover, rivers prevent the salt water of the Gulf flowing up the Shatt al-Arab waterway. However, the Iranian regime has been actively engaged in plans with the most destructive impacts of the ecological balance of the region and this desertification of the once green fields of Ahwaz. One of these plans is the transferring of water to the central provinces of Iran through diversion of the rivers. This is done regardless of the region's minimum water requirements. Several dams and diversion tunnels have been built for this purpose. For example, six tunnels were built to transfer 5 billion cubic meters of water to provinces of Isfahan and Rafsanjan. Moreover, 40 dams were built on rivers of Karun, Karkhe, and Jarahi, in addition to 36 more dams who are under construction and 176 dams under survey. At the same time, the Iranian regime has been investing on the development of the environmentally destructive sugarcane plantations created on 250,000 hectares of fertile farmland confiscated from Arab farmers. The destructive environmental impact of this project is the salty wastewater that turns the green fields of Ahwaz further downstream into barren lands. At the same time, fresh water from the Zagros Mountains is being replaced by wastewater from the western cities of the country, contributing to the environmental crisis. The plantations that traditionally sustained the livelihood of thousands of Arab farmers are now dying. Moreover, the saline wastewater stored in a large area around the city of Muhammara of evaporation has left hills of salt there to become a great threat to the health of the Arab people of Ahwaz. Due to excessive pollution of the rivers, the amount of total dissolved solid in the water has greatly increased. In the border cities of Abadan and Muhammara, it has reached four times the maximum level of potable water. Another important factor in the air pollution of the region is the deliberate evaporation of the Haralazi marsh. This is being done on a par with sudden destruction of the Iraqi marshes. Haralazi marsh has a very important role in the maintaining the ecological balance. In the Middle East, it has been completely destroyed and dried out due to activities of oil companies, according to Ali Mahmoud Shari, the vice president of Iranian Environment Organization. 500,000 hectares of marshlands of ours have dried out, and this is the main cause of sandstorm in the region. The sandstorms are a result of declining the humidity throughout the whole region. As a result, the pollutant standard index, or PSI, of the air quality in our region has passed 600 units. This is while, according to the international standards, a PSI over 300 units is critically hazardous. According to the research done by the University of Ours, about 6 million cubic meters of water yearly enter Haural Falahiyyah. The main source of this polluted water is sugarcane projects and steel industries, as well as oil companies. The destruction of Haralazi has created a crisis of wild habitats and the people in the region. As a result, residents of more than 40 villages were forced to abandon their homes and move to city slums. In our city alone, there are more than 450,000 Arabs living in slums, suffering difficult health and social conditions.
The environmental crisis in Ahwat has several negative effects on the health of the indigenous Arab people. In recent years, respiratory and lung diseases have become very common as a result of high level of air pollution, leading to many deaths. Water pollution has resulted in the skyrocketing digestive and kidney diseases. According to researches of Shafa Hospital, the number of people diagnosed with cancer increased 500% during 2000. Statistics has shown that birth defects, male and female infertility, abortions among young mothers increased dramatically in the past 2 decades in Ahwat. The experts believe that air and water pollution is the major factors behind this situation. Because of the discriminatory policies of the Iranian regime against the indigenous Arab people of Ahwat, they are deprived of the right to manage their own affairs. The crucial managing positions are assigned to non-native people coming from other provinces. These assigned officials do not consider the right of the native people of Ahwat in the water resources of the region, and the resources are expropriated to the advantage of the central provinces. The Iranian regime has no intention of stopping or even considering stopping these plans. Instead, new projects for dam destruction and water diversion are being proposed, and destructive industries which do not employ local people are contributing ever higher amounts of toxic pollution. Through changing the demography in Ahwat and destroying the environment of the region, Iran has followed the rational discrimination against Ahwazi Arabs during the last 9 decades in order to eliminate our nation, in a clear violation of the United Nations General Assembly Declaration Elimination, RES 1819-04, issued in 1963. Iran has showed an irresponsible behavior through ecology devastating in Al-Ahwaz. This regime has committed ecological crime according to the international law. The environmental crisis happening in Ahwaz is a crime against humanity that targeted the Ahwazi nation. Environmental catastrophe in Ahwaz impelled the undersigned Ahwazi activists and parties to ask the Amnesty International to take an immediate action against what's happening in Ahwaz and urge the Iranian government to stop the policy of environmental degradation in Al-Ahwaz. Thank you for listening.